So my name's Robin Carhart-Harris. I head up a research group at Imperial College London. We're the Centre for Psychedelic Research. We focus on how psychedelic drugs work in the brain and how they may be therapeutically useful. So these terms of passive and active coping are they're not new terms. I borrowed them in my own theoretical work, and I find them useful categories for thinking about serotonin, the chemical system, the neuromodulatory system that psychedelic drugs work on. And for me, it helps me think about the different drugs that work on the serotonin system for mental illness, so psychiatric drugs, you know. And the classic established ones that we have are the classic antidepressants, like the Prozac type drugs. These are called selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors, and they generally sort of broad brush increase serotonin functioning in the brain. I like to think of that effect, that functional effect, as aiding passive coping. And by that, I mean the effect of those drugs is to help you get by. They're not really restorative in any deep and true sense. It's more about taking the edge off. You're not doing anything, it's passive, but chemicals come in that you take every day, maybe a couple of times a day, and it's sort of stopping, you know, the uptake of serotonin and allowing these levels to build up over time. And that's working to kind of mute the responsiveness of emotional centers and stress circuitry in the brain. And because of that, you know, when there are situations that might stress us, that might even break us sometimes, they're less likely to break us when we're medicated with an SSRI. And that could be useful if life is really, really tough and you are at a breaking point and you do indeed just want to get by without having to do any obvious hard work. However, I'm of the school of thought, and I tend to think that the treatment of mental illness will generally go in this direction, that we need to do some work. If you want the fullest kind of healing, and shift towards wellness, then you need to do a bit of work. There's a bit of hard work to be done. In the same way that if you want to get really healthy and fit, maybe there's a bit of hard work there. Maybe, you know, you have to be a bit stricter with your diet and do some exercise. It's just the way the world works. I think the same is true with mental health. And so you have this active coping, which is the way I like to think of psychedelic therapy and how that's different to being on SSRIs. And that's about you're afforded this opportunity, sure, by an initial molecular action, an initial drug action. You can't escape that. You've taken something, a chemical, it's worked on your brain in a particular way, but then it opens up this opportunity, this window of opportunity. And then you can choose to either seize that opportunity and do something, whether that's during the experience itself, or probably more sort of appropriately afterwards. There's a door that's opened, and you can walk through it if you want to. And it, you know, what's through that door might be very, very scary. But if you walk through it and empower yourself in that way and literally look your demons in the eye, then that's the kind of approach, with the right kind of support and integration work and commitment, personal commitment. Other people can't do it all for you. You've got to do it for yourself. And if you have that commitment towards wellness, then that's what I'd refer to as an active coping.